About controlling your assets again. I mean, we started touching on some of the red flags with Nick Lentini, and we wanted to talk about, we talked about the importance of having a balanced portfolio because right now, Gino astutely talked about we're at highs. We're at some of the all-time highs for the Dow, the Nasdaq, the S&P, and there could be a dramatic pullback. And if you're not protected, then that could be very dramatic and stressful for you. But if you're working with a professional that is preparing you for that, like Nick, then it won't stress you out because I believe the main thing I have learned over time is that investments are not short term. Am I right?
Depends. I mean, you have a
Because
big,
I know real estate is not. We've learned that lesson.
generally with I can speak with what our clientele and what the make is of it, because there's definitely short-term investments as well. But the bulk of our clientele and how we work, which I can speak to, different firms focus on different things. Long-term investing is the focus of our firm in retirement planning. College planning and using also insurance to protect for people's needs, in case things happen. You discussed or mentioned a balanced portfolio. Having a good balanced portfolio using a combination of products, using a fee-based product to keep costs low and keeping your fees down. We'll talk a little bit about that as well. Some people are in want to use the protection of a variable annuity for protection of assets and having the ability to capture gains as the market grows, but have protection from a drop in the market with a minimum interest rate that is credited. Other people like fixed annuities, which of course, with our fixed interest rates so low, they're not as popular right now, but they're there as well. And then mutual funds. And then addressing what sort of mutual fund portfolio to have, or do you use one of these products? Do you use a combination of these products? And that seems to be, excuse me, that seems to be the most common thing is what's happening these days. People are using a balanced approach of saying, okay, here's our long-term funds. We want to protect it here. Let's put this portion into a
Right.
variable annuity contract, and then the remaining would go into a fixed account to keep the cost down. I'm sorry, not a fixed account, but a fee-based account to keep the cost down. So they're paying a one lump sum fee per year. Generally, it ranges between 1 and 1.5%, depending upon the amount of the money invested. And they know their fees. They know everything right up front with a fee-based account. That's the one benefit is it's one flat fee for the year, no matter how many trades we make, how we move funds around internally from conservative to aggressive to moderate inside that account. So in disclosure is a big deal. I believe we were talking fees earlier, and it's very important that disclosure. And one thing you want to make sure you do with your broker, your financial planner, say, okay, well, I've got this account in this portfolio, in this portfolio. What's my cost? What's my total cost? What's it cost me to have those funds in that account? And how does it come out? And those are questions I get more often than not
I think
lately. People are
disclosure is
becoming,
really
disclosure is a
important.
big deal.
I
It's
mean, we
very
just
big.
had a client that just said they went, it wasn't our client. It's a client we actually, again, fixing another deal. They went through the process and weren't even told they had mortgage insurance on their loan. They weren't even disclosed that. And it was a difference of $300 or so a month on their mortgage payment. That was pretty dramatic.
We get a tremendous amount of people who bring statements in and have no concept of what they own. And they put it on our desk and say, well, this is what we have, and we haven't talked to our planner in a long time. We've had this 8, 10 years. What is it? And we'll start dissecting it, and I'll go through it. And I've got a good resource. I got my dad there as well to go back to and say, hey, take a look at this. I'm not sure about this. Will you give it a look? So we give a good second look at things, or I have a good second look at it. And it's amazing what people have and don't truly understand what they're paying for it, what it's doing for them, and how it
Or
works.
not doing for them.
And
Or
or not doing for them.
not. I've had that myself.
And one of the hardest financial vehicles to understand and navigate are variable annuities. Or, well, let's be realistic, annuities in general. Variable annuities are one product or variation of that we do a tremendous amount of business with. We just like how they work. They seem to fit most of our clients' needs. as part of their investment platform. But knowing what you're paying for that annuity, what the guidelines, what the surrender charges are, the negatives of a variable annuity are generally liquidity, the cost associated with a variable annuity, and the surrender time period. And there's all that's a big scale to look at. We've seen some pretty bad variable annuities from many years ago.
Anyways. I had one of those.
Yeah.
And I can speak from that because honestly, it was horrible. I mean, I did not know what I was getting into. I trusted somebody, but they were not a professional. I was involved. Unfortunately, I didn't go to someone like Nick initially. And Nick, you are helping my family out right now, my wife and I, with our portfolio. And I am a complete ease. You explained every scenario. You went to a T. Even when I'm like, I got it. You're like, no, I'm going to explain it to you because I want to make sure you understand your options with your particular scenario. And I thank you for that because that was huge. And I learned something from that.
I appreciate that, Don. And the key is people want it simplified. Tell me what the nuts and bolts of it. I don't even know. I just want to know what's going to work and how it's going to work. Give me the... what's the worst case scenario? Give me what we can expect the long-term end result to be. And we have the ability to do that. And going back on the cost of the annuities, you get what you pay for. Mm-hmm. One of those. And the annuities are more expensive, but they bring a lot of things to the table with. And we can go into that at another time where you wanted to talk in more detail about the inner workings of that.
And I look forward to that. It's going to be a great session.
That's the whole show, trust me.
Or actually, just call us. You can find out more about this by calling us at 855-DON-GINO, 855-DON-GINO. And we will make sure you get in touch with Nick. But, Nick, I know they can get a hold of you. How can they get a hold of you on your website and your phone number?
Our website is lentiniinsuranceandinvestments.com, all spelled out. Or the best thing, just call our phone number at the office is 661-254-7633, and my extension is 14. So to wrap up that quick topic, as long as you're aware, everything is disclosed on any product. And don't be afraid, we're talking red flags, ask your broker, your planner questions. Ask them questions. Give them all the information that you have for them to do an adequate job. And
full disclosure on your part then, huh?
On your part, yeah, because, you know, it's...
it goes both ways, right?
Well, yeah. Absolutely, because you can't put someone into a long-term investment plan all of a sudden, 6 months down the road, I need this money. Well, we put this, earmarked this for a long investment horizon, and now it's going to cost more money.
Yeah, you clarified that with me. I know that.
So there's options. And going through the scenarios, the what if happens. So,
In fact, if you just tuned in, you're listening to Nick Lentini, a regular contributor here on the Don and Gino Real Estate and Finance Show. And the common thread for the last few minutes that I'm hearing is liquidity. Don't forget to have liquidity in your portfolio.
Right.
We know that life happens sometimes. And if you're not prepared for it, not only do you need to have long-term investments, mid-term investments, short-term investments, things you control, there has to be a liquid piece for an emergency. What if you lose your job? What if someone gets sick, goes on disability, something like that? You need to have some liquidity. Is that right?
Absolutely. And not to beat on the annuity dead horse that I've been on, but
it's a good product.
There are the newer annuity contracts from years ago have more flexibility for access to income, but it's also most important when sitting down originally to have a good portion of your funds liquid to access that, so you're not upsetting what that annuity is doing for you as far as
letting it do what it's supposed to be doing
because you're only hurting yourself and hurting that contract by having to take money from it.
Yeah, and I like what you said, Gino. That was very astute because that other four-letter word, life happens.
Yeah, it just does.
And it does. I mean, we even...
Kids,
when we put
school stuff.
Absolutely.
It just
I know
happens.
When we talked about that when we put people in the homes that we make sure they have some liquidity left. A lot of people want to put every dime into their home, and we warn them, you're going to want to do stuff to your home when you move into the home. Oh, no, we just want the home. That's all we care about. No way. We have never met anybody that has moved in a home that hasn't wanted to do paint, carpet, has to get blinds, has to fix something, has to paint something. I mean, it's amazing.
Landscaping. Holy cow. I remember the first spring I had to redo my backyard. I was like, how much?
Yeah.
It's
like,
just plants.
Yeah.
And it never ends.
Yeah.
It never ends.
That's true. $1,200 at Home Depot already. Well, so much for that not spending. But so the liquidity is an important piece.
Exactly. And so I think, you know, that's just a very important topic of a comprehensive plan. And one thing is, locally we have a tremendous resource of professionals, whether, like, you guys work with Steve Korn at Newhall Escrow. Lou Esman, I know, is on your show. There's a great...
We're going to go into that in just a minute.
I want to go in depth
because when we come back, we're going to talk about the importance of working with local professionals that are accountable to you, been accountable to this community, that are involved in your community right here, as we are, as Nick is. And we're going to touch base on that a little bit more, because this is a group of individuals that are here to change your life, just like we are on the Don and Gino Real Estate and Finance Show on your hometown station, AM 1220 KHTS.